I'm very happy to be here for the launch of TX Hospitals, their second center here in Pachigura after the grand success of their first center in Bhopal. I am very, very assured that you and your family will be given affordable healthcare with great services from very, very efficient doctors that I have sitting next to me. So I have a few questions for some of them, and actually questions that all of us have on our minds right now, including me. So I would definitely be looking forward to their answers. My first question is to Dr. Ramalu. Hello, sir. How do we manage COVID positive patients for surgical interventions?
So there are two things in this. Surgical problem, the COVID positive patients presenting with surgical problems. There are two sets now. One is emergency, the other is elective surgical process. If this problem is emergency one, emergency surgery one, no matter whatever is the condition of the patient, we have to take up for surgery. Otherwise, we may lose the patient.
So what are the precautions?
And then mostly these cases are acute and acute cholecystitis and intestinal obstructions, so these cases we have to pick up immediately, otherwise we will lose the patient. And most of the times the surgeries which can be done under regional anesthesia, we have to prefer the regional anesthesia. And electric problems like dogs, these cases we can hold on.
But are you doing general anesthesia safely?
Yes, we have to be safe. Otherwise, we may lose the patient because of this.
Correct, and not really because of COVID. Yeah. So we take all the precautions.
We have to protect the ODI and OD staff.
Yes.
So all these things are involved.
But you are taking that risk.
Yes.
You are going to answer the question? The recent trend shows increased tendency of stroke in the young population. What is the main reason for it and how to tackle this problem? Actually, a friend of mine who was 40 just had a stroke and really shook all of us up. So this is a question I personally want to know the answer to.
So by definition, stroke in young refers to the patients who are getting stroke less than 40 years of age. The most common reason everybody knows is the familial history. If at all their parents or grandparents or the maternal side, uncles, if they are positive for any kind of stroke factors, definitely yes. This is a known factor since ages. But recent off-late trend is like the sedentary lifestyle, especially in the software engineers who are 25 to 30 years of age. They settle very early. Now even work from home also, they tend to sit at one place and back in the physical activity. This has been a very, very root cause for all the stroke recently. Tremendously the incidence has increased till now, almost 20% rise in the incidence in younger patients.
And it's only because of
sedentary lifestyle, lack of physical activity and healthy, I mean the food habits also. We tend to ordering online burgers and any fast food centers. And main cause is the lack of physical activity, and also added on to it the mental stress. You know, everybody has the targets, you know, at the end of month or they need to finish off the projects or anything by the particular time. So apart from physical inactivity and adding to that, the mental stress is adding to them. So mental stress is most important, and we have seen the heart strokes also, which is a common thing with this.
Can you suggest maybe a test that you can take once a year or once in 6 months?
True.
Is that a prevention in some way?
Definitely, yes. We can get a lipid profile done, liver function test done, and also ECG. Normally, when at rest, we tend to have normal pulse rate, and but when we tend to walk for a distance or when get too close high, then we start getting shortness of breath. So that should be that is evaluated on a treadmill test. You know what we call treadmill. In a normal ECG, they would have a normal baseline, because at rest they are comfortable in their comfort zone. Once they are put to stress, like in treadmills, then the things start coming. So those patients who are at risk zone, like obesity patients and these lifestyle patients,
from the outside and we think nothing will happen to us. So how often would you suggest taking a test to check your liver function, your ECG?
or any other test.
Or any other test for, you know, for the stroke. Probably be aware that there's a sudden increase in strokes, in cardiac arrest. So how often do not ignore your, you know, yearly checkups. Your, you might seem healthy, everything might be might be fine, but please do not ignore your daily, your yearly health checkups. Thank you, doctor.
Thanks.
What are the common consequences post COVID-19 recovery, long term and short term?
We have been treated at the last almost 7 to 8 patients.
Oh wow, okay. So how did you do that, doctor?
I checked that guy was not given proper history of which way he was coming. He was like reducing the cough and cold and short. So we are given, even taken the cough, but it was paid at travel history. So where he got the at that point, it was very
Can you please elaborate about the PCOD as you call it these days?
PCOD is very common now.
Because of the starting younger and younger.
Yes. Yeah. Because of the hormones of mothers. Because there is a lot of food, there is a lot of contamination.
So what would you suggest, you know, I remember like when we were children, my mother said drink milk, but now you realize that, okay, the milk is full of hormones that affect the baby. So, you know, everything, every time we need a new set of set of things that educate us, right? So now what would you educate the young girls?
First of all, we have to do
adverse effects. I know this is a question that everyone is worried about, with half information, with no information at all, widespread fear. What are the adverse effects of COVID vaccines? So please clear our doubts.
We don't have to be panicked.
What are the reasons of high incidence of diabetes in
actually, in young age, it is type 1 diabetes. Wherein the insulin production is not very easy. We diagnose it as type 1 diabetes. It's not directly on insulin. Very light, it comes to the elderly. And the pancreas gets exhausted. So it's supplying the insulin since birth.
And I'm in the midst of very, very efficient doctors, so I don't even think that I have to recommend. They just did it by themselves. So I'm very happy to be here at the launch of your second center, and I'm sure there's going to be many more centers in the near future. Wishing the TX Hospitals Group a very, very warm and a loving future, and I hope that they heal many, many more lives.
Thank you.
హాయ్ యోస్, ఛానల్ను సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేయడం మర్చిపోవద్దు, గంట కొట్టడం అస్సలు మర్చిపోవద్దు.